I'm Janse Schermerhorn. I'm a chemistry and biochemistry double major and a rising captain of the varsity men's soccer team. This summer, I'm working with Dr. Gabriel Brandt in a biochemistry lab. We're working on discovering protein structures through crystallography. We had just got back from South Africa. We spent two weeks there getting to explore and see what South Africa has to offer for a men's soccer team. I've always considered medicine to be the path for me. I really feel that I have an opportunity as a physician to help guide people through tough times. I knew that Franklin Marshall had a lot to offer in terms of getting me where I wanted to go academically, and as well had a really strong soccer program with a band of brothers that were really close. The culture of this team is one that focuses a lot on getting the most out of everybody on the team. Our coach will be the first to tell you that we're worth a lot more than just our position on the field. The men's soccer team just went to Khayelitsha, South Africa. That's a small township right outside of Cape Town. We got to work with some of the most impoverished and most endangered kids. Going to South Africa really was a life-changing perspective for me. We weren't going about it in any way that we're there to do some service project. We were there to connect with them and just kind of become friends with them, play soccer with them, really a universal language. And I think this goes along with the aspect of Franklin and Marshall men's soccer that emphasizes the holistic nature of a person and not that we're just soccer players. Like, how can we use soccer to better ourselves, to better others, and to learn about the world around us? Going into my junior season, I had a stress fracture. I didn't know about it at the time, and I was playing on it. I knew I wasn't healthy, and I wasn't feeling great, and as a result, I wasn't playing great, and that was definitely a tough spot for me. I started to lose playing time, started to lose confidence, and I found myself as a first-year captain on the bench, and I had to take about 5 months completely off of soccer. My leadership style had always been one leading by example, and it was really difficult to be able to say, yeah, hey, like, let's run this one more sprint, let's do our best, when I didn't even know if I could, if I could bring that to the table every day. I had to kind of internally figure out a way for me to be able to lead from the sideline. Can I be the guy that's getting everybody going? Can I be the guy that's trying to get the most out of my teammates still, but in a totally different way than before?
Jim, make sure we're seeing out the game. We got like...
I now just recently consider myself 100% and ready to train my hardest, which leaves me a good amount of time to say that I'll be hopefully fully prepared to help my team in whatever way I can. One of the most crucial things for me is learning about myself throughout this process. Being a doctor has always been a profession to me that's so much more than just understanding sciences. It's understanding people, it's understanding relationships and teamwork and how to get the most out of somebody else, and knowing that it is a group effort almost at all times and that there are very few things that one can accomplish on their own. These 4 years are going to be some of the most formative of my life, and that realistically, I wouldn't be the same person or doctor in the future without them. I only have 4 years here, and I cherish every one of them for sure.